Okay, hello. This video is on adding in scientific notation. Okay, a quick review of what we learned in our introduction to scientific notation. We said that m times 10 to the n is how we write in scientific notation. So scientific notation is a way to write a very large number into a shorthand way. It has two factors, and they produce the larger number product. Okay, so the first factor, we call it a coefficient, and this coefficient, this factor, has to have at least a value of 1, but cannot be more than 10. Okay, and then it's multiplied by a base of 10 to an exponential power. Okay, so this is scientific notation right here. We'll talk about our rule in just a little bit when we get to more difficult problems. Okay, so let's look at this problem right here. We have 4.2 times 10 to the third plus 3.1 times 10 to the third. Okay, we want to get our problem where we have the same power of 10. So in this case, we have both power of 10 of 10 to the third. That's what we want. When we have that, we can simply add 4.2 plus 3.1, and all that's going to be multiplied by 10 to the third power. And 4.2 plus 3.1 is 7.3 times 10 to the third power. Okay, the second problem. Again, we have 10 to the fourth, 10 to the fourth. That's what we want. Same exponential power. So we have 3.3 plus 1.6 times 10 to the fourth power. We add those together, we get 4.9 times 10 to the fourth power. And that's our answer. Okay, so the third one. Again, we have 10 to the 16th, 10 to the 16th. So our answer will have 10 to the 16th in it, but we have 2.8 plus 6.3, and again, times 10 to the 16th power. And we add those together, we're gonna have 9.1 times 10 to the 16th power. 9.1. All right. Now, let's look at some that are a little bit more difficult. Okay, let's look at this example. We have 4.6 times 10 to the 17th plus 3.8 times 10 to the 16th. Okay, now in this case, we have powers of 10 that are to different exponents. So we need to get the exponents to the same power. All right, we can either decrease this one or increase this one. We're going to do it both ways. So first time, we're going to decrease this to 10 to the 16th. All right, that's still gonna be plus, this will stay the same, 3.8 times 10 to the 16th. Okay, so we have a rule. If we decrease power decreases, we're gonna move the decimal to the right. All right, so we decrease by 1, we're gonna move the decimal to the right by 1. So we move that to the right 1, it becomes 46 times 10 to the 16th plus 3.8 times 10 to the 16th. Okay, so now we will add 46 plus 3.8, and that is times 10 to the 16th. All right, that becomes 49.8 times 10 to the 16th. Okay, now is this scientific notation? We look over here, is at least 1? Yes. Is it less than 10? No. So we've got to move it around. We need to move it one place here. That becomes 4.98. Okay, so if we decrease this side, we've got to increase this side. That becomes 10 to the 17th. All right. Now, let's do it this time by increasing this side. So the 4.6 times 10 to the 17th will stay the same, plus, now we want 10 to the 17th. Now, if our power increases, our decimal moves to the left. So our 3.8 will move to the left and become 0.38. Okay? All right, so now we have both 10 to the 17th on both sides, both factors. We'll add 4.6 plus 0.38, and that's times 10 to the 17th. Okay? So that becomes 4.98 times 10 to the 17th. And if we confirm our answers, we get the same answer doing it both ways. Let's do another one. Okay, 8.7 times 10 to the negative 6 plus 3.2 times 10 to the negative 5. All right, again, we want our tens to have the same exponent, same power. So we'll do it both ways again. First off, we're going to change this one to a negative 5. Okay, and it'll still be plus 3.2 times 10 to the negative 5. Okay, so let's look up here. What did we do when we changed it from a negative 6 to a negative 5? Well, we actually increased it. So if the power increases, we're going to move the decimal to the left. So our new decimal will become 0.87. Okay? So now we have 0.87 plus 3.2. And all that's going to be times 10 to the negative 5. Okay? So then we'll add this together and we should get 4.07 times 10 to the negative 5. And that's our answer. Okay? So let's do it this time. Let's change this side to 10 to the negative 6. So this side will stay the same. We'll have 8.7 times 10 to the negative 6. Plus, and we're going to change this to a 10 to the negative 6. Okay. Now, we are decreasing because our negative 6 is less than negative 5. So if we decrease our power decreases, we move the decimal to the right. The other side will increase. So 3.2 becomes 32 times 10 to the negative 6. All right, now, so we add 8.7, way too high there, 8.7 plus 32 times 10 to the negative 6. All right, that becomes 40.7 times 10 to the negative 6. Okay, we're not finished because this is, yes, it's at least 1, but it's not less than 10. So we've got to change, we've got to move this one place. Okay, so now that becomes 4.07. If we decrease this side, we have to increase the power of 10. So again, to increase the power of 10, we go to negative 5, and that's our answer. Now, do these match? Yes. Okay, so we did it two ways and we came up with the same answer. You can do it either way as long as your answer is finished in scientific notation. Okay, 5.417 times 10 to the 14th plus 3.1 times 10 to the 12th. Okay, again, we want our tens to have the same exponent, so we've either got to decrease or increase. Let's increase. All right, so we're going to change this one to 10 to the 14th. This will stay the same. Now, if we power increases, we move the decimal to the left. We make this side of the multiplication sign larger, we have to make this side smaller. So we're going to increase by 2, we've got to decrease by 2, so we're going to move 1, 2, so we add a 0.031 times 10 to the 14th. All right, so now we're going to add 5.417, and we're going to add 0.031, and all that's going to be times 10 to the 14th. All right, and that will be 5.448 times 10 to the 14th. Okay, let's look at two more. 6 times 10 to the 6th plus 3.27 times 10 to the 7th. Okay, again, we want our powers of 10 to be the same, so we're going to have to increase or decrease. Let's decrease this 10. We're going to change this to 10 to the 6th. Okay, this then will stay the same. 6 times 10 to the 6th plus. Now, if we power decreases, we'll move the decimal to the right. Okay, so move the decimal to the right, becomes 32.7 times 10 to the 6th. Okay, so now we'll add 6 plus 32.7, and that's times 10 to the 6th power. Okay, that becomes 38.7 times 10 to the 6th. Now, we want it at least one less than 10. It's not less than 10, so we've got to move it to the left. That becomes 3.87 times. Now, if we decrease this side, we have to increase this side, so 10 to the 7th power, and that's our final answer. All right, let's look at this one. 7.19 times 10 to the 14th plus 5.02 times 10 to the 16th. Okay, we have 14 and a 16. All right, what did we do up here? We decreased up here, so let's increase down here. So we're going to change this to 10 to the 16 plus 5.02 times 10 to the 16. All right, so we're increasing by 2. So if our power increases, we're going to move the decimal to the left. We'll have to move the decimal to the left 2 places, 2 times. 1, 2. We'll add a 0. So it becomes 0.0719 times 10 to the 16th. We have 10 to the 16th, 10 to the 16th, so we can add. So now we have 5.02 plus 0.0719, and all that's going to be times 10 to the 16th. All right, so this becomes 5.0919 times 10 to the 16th, and that is our final answer. We're at least 1 less than 10, and we're times the power of 10. Okay, quick review. We said scientific notation is a way to take a very large number and write it shorthanded. We used two factors, a coefficient times a power of 10. And we said if we move the decimal to the right, our power decreases. If we move the decimal to the left, our power increases. All right. Well, thanks for watching. And please subscribe if you haven't already. And we'll see you on the next video.